Using OneDrive as an external drive. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for AskLeo.com. In a previous video and article, I described how you can use OneDrive without running the OneDrive app by simply visiting the OneDrive.com website. In another article, I showed you how you can use OneDrive as a dumb hard drive, again, without needing the app. I've discovered a command line tool that, honestly, is the best of both worlds, and I've started using it extensively. It's called rclone. Now, you don't need to run the OneDrive app on your computer. You can disable it, you can uninstall it, you can simply sign out of it. Any of these will prevent the OneDrive app from trying to synchronize or otherwise manipulate any files on your computer. That's the OneDrive app you're not going to use. Without the OneDrive app in use, there won't be any confusing manipulation behind the scenes. You can download rclone from rclone.org. You'll see it in the downloads page. It's available for many different operating systems. Of course, the one we will care about will be Intel AMD Windows, which is a very simple download. There's no install. You simply download the zip file, open the zip file, and then copy the rclone.exe therein to a folder of your choice. Now, it's probably frowned upon, but what I did is I just placed rclone.exe into my Windows System 32. I did that because it specifically and automatically makes the command line tool available immediately without my going in and having to change anything else like the path. The rclone model is that you first configure your connection to a remote service like OneDrive. After doing so, you can then use that connection transparently from then on. So, in a Windows command prompt, what we'll do is run rclone config. This begins the process of configuring rclone to access a remote service. In this case, I've got no remote services already configured, so I'm going to go ahead and do a new remote. I'm going to call this OneDrive. Now, it's important to understand that rclone is typically case sensitive, so uppercase OneDrive is different than lowercase OneDrive. Doesn't matter which you use, just know that you need to be consistent. Then you're given a long list of possible remote service technologies. It's in alphabetical order, and the one we care about, of course, is Microsoft OneDrive. For me, currently, that's number 36. You should make sure to check this list because the list, of course, can change over time, and it may not be number 36 for you. There are now a series of prompts that, honestly, you can ignore or at least just hit enter on because we're not going to specify anything. That includes this client ID, this client secret, this region, this tenant, and then editing the advanced config, which we do not need to do. Now, in most cases, you are going to be configuring rclone on the machine to which you're going to, on which you're going to be using it, of course, but it's probably the machine on which you also have a web browser to be able to run. So what we're going to do here is we are choosing yes, if the machine running rclone has a web browser you can use. It's the default answer, so I'll just hit enter. You can see now it has fired up a browser and it has signed in to my Microsoft account. The reason that happened automatically for me is because I was already signed into the account. If you're not already signed into the account, then it will actually go through the process of asking you for your username and your password and possibly your second factor. If you need to do this for an account other than the one you are currently signed into, just be sure to sign out before you run rclone config. At this point, it's done. It has gotten what it needs from OneDrive, so we can go back to the rclone prompt in command. Once again, we have a couple of prompts where we can just accept the defaults: config type and config drive ID. Assuming you see something similar to this, the actual CID on this will be different for you, then yes, you can just hit enter. This is a summary of the configuration. You'll see again something similar. At this point, you're done. It's okay. You have finished configuring our clone for OneDrive. So we can just hit Q for quit. Okay, great. We've gone through that process. What the heck does it all mean? How do we use it? It's actually very simple at this point. For example, if I go our clone ls, which is the Linux equivalent of a dir, a directory, it's a list command, and we'll say OneDrive, which is that string, that name that we gave it at the beginning of the configuration, followed by a colon. Boom. What it's doing now is it is listing all of the files in this account's OneDrive. If instead, all you want to do is list the folders in your OneDrive, then it would be our clone lsd for list directories. Again, OneDrive colon, and boom, it shows me what the directories are, what the folders are that I have in OneDrive. So to copy a file to OneDrive, we would go our clone copy file name, a temporary example file that I've created, OneDrive colon, and I want to put that in my transfer folder. That's a folder, the name of the folder that happens to be up in OneDrive. So again, our clone, copy, the name of the file that I want to copy, OneDrive colon, meaning that it's going to be copied to my OneDrive, transfer, in my case, that's the folder that I want this file to be placed in. Boom, the file's copied. And in fact, if we now quickly go take a look at my OneDrive online, look at my files, go into the transfer folder, and sure enough, there it is, temporaryexample.txt. Now, to do the reverse, to copy a file down to my PC, I will type our clone, copy. In this case, then we're copying from OneDrive, so we start with that. The folder the file currently exists in is my transfer folder, / internet safety -v6-free.pdf, followed by a period. The period is the destination. A period is a shorthand for the current folder. In this case, in command prompt, we can see that the current folder is c:\users\askle. That's where the file will be copied to. So we'll just hit enter. Boom. There's the file. And if I do a dir now of the current folder, you can see internet safety v6 free has been copied down. So those are very useful commands. Listing what the contents of your OneDrive, copying files to and from OneDrive, and so forth. There's another command that merits special attention, and that's the mount command. Now, in order to use mount, you're actually going to have to install an additional package called WinFSP. That comes from winfsp.dev. It's the Windows File System Proxy. It's a very simple download and install. Once you've done so, you can then do this. Our clone, mount, OneDrive, colon, space, O, colon. In this case, O is the drive letter we're going to assign to it. And then I'm also going to include an obscure option because it complains if I don't give it that option. It has meaning, of course, but the actual meaning isn't really relevant to what we're trying to look at here today. So, our clone, mount, OneDrive colon, space, O colon, a drive letter that you choose, whatever drive you want that's available, space, and then this obscure dash dash VFS dash cache dash mode space writes. Boom. The R-Clone service has been started. Okay, what happened? Nothing happened. Well, something very important happened. If I now fire up Windows File Explorer, there's a drive here called OneDrive. That's my name. That's the name I gave it when we did the configuration. If I click on that, we now see the contents of OneDrive online as if it were an external hard drive. I can double click on transfer, and sure enough, there are the files that I have created. I'm going to quickly turn on the show file extensions because I think that's important. So you can see temporary example.txt, the file we created. If I want to, say, copy a file from one place to another, now it's just a simple drag and drop. If I take copy.txt, drag it and drop it onto downloads, I have now downloaded that file from OneDrive to my downloads folder. Using it this way, OneDrive is nothing more than some online storage you can access through Windows File Explorer, like it was an external drive or any other drive. It'll be slower because it'll be dependent on the speed of your internet connection. But you won't be running the OneDrive app. There won't be any automatic synchronization. There won't be any automatic confusion. In order to dismount, well, all you really need to do then is come back here to this thing where we've got the service still running and hit Control C. Boom. The drive has been unmounted. Drive O has disappeared. So, bottom line here. Use OneDrive on your PC or not as you see fit. But understand you can use it completely via the web without any of that synchronization and background magic with the app uninstalled. Or you can use it using R-Clone, either in command line or as a way to mount your remote OneDrive as if it were just another drive. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177993. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.